Aloha, sons and waters. This is going to be an interesting message. All morning, I kept hearing, don't let evil in, don't let evil win. So there could be someone around you that may be trying to enter your life. I'm even hearing re-enter. And this is someone that you know they can't be trusted. And I feel like deep down you want to let them in, but your higher self knows better. All right. And I'm also feeling like this person comes around when things are getting tough on their end. Like, I feel like I talked about this last year. So this must be a running theme for Cancer Leo season. Like, a lot of people facing judgment, a lot of people facing karma for what they did in the past. And it's like they want to drop their karma onto you. I'm seeing someone save this person, someone let someone back in who has a lot of baggage, a lot of dues that need to be paid spiritually, maybe even here in the physical as well. And I'm just seeing this person with the, it's giving me like plague energy, like this, like it's very contagious is what I'm seeing. And it's not a physical virus. This is something spiritual, something emotional, something mental. And it's contagious is what I'm hearing. Like you could spend a day with this person and they will flip your life upside down. And it may not seem like that in the moment. Like in the moment, it may seem fun. It may seem familiar. Oh, I miss this. But I'm seeing like someone's life getting flipped upside down. Someone's career, someone's finances, someone's relationship. Whether this be a relationship with self, your children, maybe you have a partner. And let's just see what the cards have to say about this. Like it's giving urgent. Like I kept hearing it's urgent, it's urgent. And they were actually sharing this message with me this morning. And I kind of pushed it away. I didn't want to really deal with it. I didn't want to tap into it and channel this message. But they're saying it's urgent. And I'm the messenger, so what, you know? So I gotta deliver the message. So what is this, spirit? What is this? Don't let evil in. Don't let evil win. Six of Swords. This could have been someone that you moved on from. Or maybe they even moved on from you. They left you. There was someone that was left here. But I'm seeing you as well. You moved past this person already. You moved past it. You got over it. You got over it. And I feel they feel that as well. Like it's giving me the vibe. Like when you pull your power back, watch who comes running. And this person is coming back running because they feel this sense of emptiness. Because they built their life off the energy that they siphoned from you. Yeah, this person could have kept a lot of secrets as well. I feel like this person's really secretive. Ghost. I'm getting like ghosting energy. Come and go, in and out. Maybe giving you dry stories, selling you a fucking story. Tell me more about this energy. Don't let evil in. Don't let evil win. Heartbreak. Three of Swords. This is someone that broke your heart, someone that separated from you. And I'm hearing like it fucking hurt. I'm feeling the pain. They hurt me and they hurt me good. They hurt me bad. Caused a lot of depression, a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of insomnia, depression, anxiety. And I feel like this is what you moved on from. You moved past this already. And I feel like because someone moved past this, they may be I'm getting this energy of feeling torn. Feeling torn, like you could be wanting to give this person a chance. I'm hearing everyone deserves another chance, but I'm hearing this person doesn't. Because you're headed for a major breakthrough. I'm seeing doors being opened up for you. But if you are around this person, that doors are going to get slammed in your face. This is not their blessings. They can't come with you on this journey, this new life that's ahead of you. They can't come with you. How would they know who this person is? How would they know who this person is? Page of Pentacles. It could be a younger earth sign. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. I'm also feeling like this person always came bearing gifts. Maybe that made up for their absence, for their ghosting. Hats. There's something about hats. This person could really like using hats. I'm getting Joker type energy though. A Joker. Scheme. How else would they know who this person is? Ace of Cups. Someone that you really loved. Someone that you thought was a blessing from divine. A blessing in disguise. I'm getting lilies. This person could have bought you lilies. Their initial could be W or M, or it could be significant here somehow. I just heard World Cup. This person, I'm even hearing they could be an alcoholic. Let's get another card for who this person is. Who is this person that they shouldn't let into their life? How would they know who this person is? Confusion. Someone that causes confusion. Someone that walked away from you. Someone that abandoned you. How would they know who this person is that I'm speaking of, Spirit? Someone. I'm getting heavy earth vibes, earth signs. This person could have recently lost a job. Maybe this person was always financially unstable. I'm hearing they could be a gambler. They could like gambling, drinking. What is this person's intentions for coming back in? What is this person's intentions? Damn. I feel like it's a test. It's a test. They're coming in to give you clarity on where you stand. They're coming in to show you that you have made a major breakthrough. I feel like the breakthrough is you declining their offer. But I'm also seeing like they're coming back in because they want your clarity. What are this person's intentions? Why are they coming in? They could be coming in for your money. Maybe they need some money. You could have got a huge inheritance recently, or you're just building an empire for yourself. Really financially stable. I'm seeing they need money. What's the advice for the collective here in regards to this situation? What's the advice? Wow. The Devil card. That's interesting. But what I just heard was something about restrictions. Restrict. This person needs to be restricted from coming towards you. You need to keep your distance. Because they're trying to chain themselves for you. Spirit wants you to see this. They're trying to chain themselves to you. They're trying to also chain you to the devil. Like, that could be the energy of, like, just a day with him could flip, or this person could flip your life upside down. Like, maybe you've been sober and then you start drinking. You start gambling, falling into some sort of addictions, codependency. I feel like this person wants you to need them how they need you. What's the advice for the collective in regards to this energy? Observe. I'm hearing don't respond, just observe how this person moves. How this person responds to you not responding. Any more advice? Yeah, I feel like this person could become really aggressive to you not saying anything. And it's like if they use some sort of aggression towards you, I'm hearing make sure you speak your truth. You tell them how you feel. You tell them what it is. Yeah, I'm getting like anger. This person could really piss you off. Any more advice? Well, let's get an outcome. What's the outcome for this energy? Yes. There's going to be a lot of invites. This person's going to be trying to get you to come out, acting as if it's a blessing that they're in your life. Like, this person feels like you're blessed to have them. And you're just like, no, the fuck, I do not want anything to do with you. I don't want to be your fucking friend. I don't want to be your lover. I don't want any, I don't want any of that. It's like poison, like you're declining it, like you're not wanting this. It's poison, it's toxic. Give me another outcome for this energy. I see your finances becoming really stable because you don't fall for their trap. The outcome is you're able to walk through that door that's been open for you, and you pass the test.